when you're watching this video on something. Starting problem, I couldn't talk outside my house. I ain't been well in school camp. I ain't gonna fucking out of school. I'm on my third marriage. I lost everything I own twice. I've been homeless and living in poverty. I'm gonna tell you what I know. This ain't no fancy rich boy. No people don't know. You ain't got to find no program. You ain't got to go sign up. I'm telling you what I'm gonna tell you. If you apply right now to change your existence, because everybody I know will be happy. Everybody I know will be successful. If you don't want to do things, it's all over to you. So now here, that was a script that I'm gonna give. It's a very small script, very short. I don't even know where it is in the Bible. Somebody probably know if I say it, but I'm gonna give it to you. This script will change my life. You have not, because you're anxious. You have any idea how amazing those words are for you? You have not, because you ask not. It's such a simple scripture. But it's in your Bible. It ain't just in rich people's Bible. It's in the same copy you got. You have not, because you ask not. This is the truest statement you'll hear me say today. Because it's true. Most people don't have the life of their dreams, because you don't ask God for the life of your dreams. You've been trying to figure it out and damage yourself. Well, how that's working out. You know how hard that is to do it? Because I did it. I did it for 30-some years. I tried to figure it out myself. Man, all the simple scripture says, you have not because you ask God. If you have your ass, automatically you already give.
Okay, let's take it out with number one. Being patient. After the first 100 videos that I made for my ADHD channel, I had 78 subscribers. Now, I talk about this, I don't really believe me because they see the way the channel looks now, and it's hard to believe, but yeah, for 100 videos, I had 78 subscribers. So if you guys are, you know, reeling with that, that no one's watching your videos, and you made 50 videos, and you have 50 subscribers, that's probably a really good sign. It's been a long time since I started that. New creators. New creators being pretty broad because you can be a new creator in tech or a comedy or a new photographer. You know, there's all kinds of new creators. But on YouTube, generally, like if I was starting over today, by reviewing tech or whatever you have, that seems really obvious. But people might be like, oh, I don't have money to spend on tech to buy and review right now. But you know, I started in high school when I just bought one laptop because that's what I needed for school. And I made dozens and dozens of videos. And the next person who's trying to decide what laptop to buy for school about the one that I bought. So you might not think you have tech, but you're watching this video on something, map keyword you like, map else you like, and you know that it's a tech or anything else because you're using it. So all you have to do is take out your phone or take out some camera or some device that you can use. That's what it all comes down to, is a purchase decision, with the keywords. If you can help someone trying to purchase your tech review, and my advice for starters is just that, get started. A lot of people are thinking about, like I said again, what should you do, what should buy, start making videos, or what they should get together to begin. It's not really about that, it's just about what you make. And then once you make your first few videos, then you can get better from there. You'll have a shot with your first video. Don't worry about it, it will be better when you get started. You want to work on just your dream job, or just watching this video and the advice. What's your dream job? What's your dream job? You can get sure what interests you. Obviously, if you're passionate about something, then you have a much better chance of success to do against someone who's not really a passionate about it. So when you're passionate, you put in extra work, and that's what gets the advantage. You really need to impact in that field. Also, if you want more excellence and black community videos, check out my 2 weeks before excellence series. The link is in the description. Everything I didn't want to do is what got me where I'm at today. Especially in college. I'm going to watch more stuff that is like your success too on YouTube. New tech videos. So I think the obvious answer there is tech has been interesting and important for so long that just being in the tech space generally, but I want this, has done a lot for it. Yeah. The channel itself, there's plenty of other successful tech channels, but that's Tony's style. That's a consistent voice to me for 10 years. Yeah. So I guess just, if you combine all those factors, consistency plus tech staying interesting, that's I get asked a lot about, like, you know, can I point to a certain video or a date or month or something, like what happened to go from like nothing to where it is now? Because I've come to this day, I look back, it's mainly just like, you can get charts, even, it's just a sort of upward slope from 0 videos to 1,000 videos. You know, it's obviously when you get to certain points, like, the reputability, is that a word? The reputability of the channel becomes more significant, so you're more likely to subscribe to it. Like, that guy with a million subscribers talking about something you should buy, then the guy with 100, so that's helped, but I feel like consistency is made.
Do the best job. Make sure everything is okay. I need to know why. Like, just you do. Like, you're just watching on the phone. This looks good right now. Like, this looks like anything else that you're, but I mean, I don't know. I feel like there's no point to it. I need to help you understand or find you, but then I get infirm there almost. Like, what they call the law of diminishing returns. Like, you can't very often get a I could share everything I want, you know, if you're on 200 and you're talking about the exact same thing, and you're talking about the content of the video every day, and you're just going to be like, oh, what's that last little bit that's hard to reproduce and hard to tangibly understand that you get from, not just shooting 8K, but from red color sizes and shooting across, that is just my own personal side touch. The little bit of detail, the crispness, the little bit of thing, I feel like maybe 1% of the viewer might feel it. 1% of the viewer I'm going to make a lot of screencasts, uploaded a bunch of software tutorials and things like that. And with the comments that people started to mention on those videos, they'll say, oh, I enjoyed this video, why don't you also enjoy a video about this other thing? So I'd say, okay, I'm just making that video too, just cracking out.
I made the wrong impression.
And so I developed this little community of people talking about tech and just making videos for those people and just kind of moving from there. Ooh, don't obsess with
a comment. Or I can do that too. Like, if you end up, like, I always see myself performing, like, professional system stuff. I remember doing, like, SAT stuff where it's like, okay, you have to write this essay, you have the topic, and then you have to write it right then. But I want to think about this for a couple days before I actually perform the paper, and like, you just have to spend 3 days and hopefully it's enough. Like, the way you should just, like, the new phone just came out. Like, you don't get to sit on this for a while. You form the best thing you can, and it's 95% there, and it's done. That's better than 99% there, and still working on it. That's a barrier for me. I wish I could take more time with a lot of stuff. But it's just fantastic to have to evolve your production and really make a decent thing. Who is your biggest inspiration for your videos, for your work? I think you're probably expecting me to say, like, a couple of YouTubers' names. Because maybe that's sound dumb, but that's the kind of stuff I'd like to be able to do. Do
another 10 or 15 videos by the whole thing.
About 6-7 years now. I've been playing since the record grade in middle school, and I started playing really competitive, I guess, my freshman year of high school. Now I'm in my second year of college. But I also get to end second, but also I have to golf a lot as well. And I need to count right now. I'm going to play, you know, Wildsley's really cool. But yeah, the two biggest sports I play are all improving and golf, and personal golf is a pretty good player. Yeah.
Information.